So it's been about a month now of living with an iPhone. Let's find out if Apple can convert me or not. So for the past month, I've been using pretty much everything iPhone. I have an iPhone 6S in this absolutely fabulous rose gold colour, an Apple Watch Series 0, which I borrowed from my boyfriend, which is more than fine for my needs. I only use an Apple Watch and, well, a smartwatch in general for notifications. I even bought a pair of Apple EarPods. Ooh, a bit disgusting. Also, towards the end of this whole month thing, I decided to get an iPhone smart battery case because, well, most iPhone users will understand why, but I'll explain it later. So let's actually start with the hardware of this. Now, this is a strong point for Apple. Apple have always made pretty decent feeling hardware. And that's because Apple really do have a lot of focus on the design. They put more effort into the design of their products than they do anything else. Unfortunately, because they put more effort into the design, there is some weaknesses. Both my iPhone and the Apple Watch have some cracked screens. And the iPhone in particular seems to have scratched really easily. I don't put the phone in my pocket with keys or anything. I don't put the phone in my pocket with coins or anything. I put it in an empty pocket. I usually have it face outwards so it's not like rubbing against my jeans or anything. I can imagine if you give this to a woman with a handbag, it would just basically be destroyed within 2 minutes. What the hell, Apple? I've never had a phone scratch so easily. Another problem with the iPhone is the battery life, which is just garbage. And it's not just because I'm using an iPhone 6S. My boyfriend's got an iPhone 7. He's had it since brand new. And even he leaves it in the battery saver mode all the time because it's not really usable otherwise. I don't know what Apple's doing that makes the battery drain so quick. There is also some just strange software quirks in the iPhone. For example, clearing notifications takes 2 swipes. Yet on Android, I can just hit a single button and clear them all, which is much nicer, and you can just do a single swipe for each notification. It's not a very user-friendly design choice. I mean, I understand why Apple have done it. It's so that people don't accidentally dismiss notifications, but as someone who doesn't do that by accident, I would much rather just a single swipe to get rid of a notification. Come on, Apple. And it just gets downhill from here. The software on these iPhones is just pretty garbage. If I wanted to run apps, I have to go through the App Store, obviously. I can't just download an APK, and Apple have very strict rules. For example, I can't get a Wi-Fi analyzer, which is something I use a lot as a geeky guy. I am often going and doing Wi-Fi stuff for people. The other day I was installing a couple of access points in a pretty big house, and I was using my Android phone, analyzing all the Wi-Fi channels, seeing where I was getting signal and where I wasn't, and it was working perfectly. But if I was to use the iPhone, I can't get that. That's not to say the Apple experience is all bad. There's a lot of apps on the iPhone I actually prefer. Like, I prefer Find My Friends to the Google Maps location sharing feature. Find My Friends is just quite nice. I also feel that just the general apps that are included with the iPhone, like the Mail app, the Calendar app, they're all quite decent. They work well with Microsoft Exchange, which is something that cannot be said for the Microsoft Outlook app. Yeah, it's kind of ironic that. And things like Touch ID work really well. The camera on this iPhone is so nice. I've never had such a nice camera on a phone before. But ultimately, it's a personal preference, and the lack of Wi-Fi analyzer and the fact that I need to add this pretty ugly case just to get a usable battery life out of this phone, it's kind of a shame really, because I actually kind of like this device, but the lack of stuff that I use daily, like battery and Wi-Fi analyzer, well, I don't really use that daily, but I do use the battery daily, and the iPhone just doesn't have that. So ultimately, I'm probably going to be switching back to Android, but for now, I'm actually going to stick with the iPhone simply because it is a nicer phone than my daily driver, because my daily driver is a pretty old BlackBerry Priv. Yeah. So the iPhone was up against some of the worst Android phones, actually. I haven't had a like top tier Android phone for ever. So my comparisons are quite... they're not biased here, I don't think. I like the iPhone, I really do. It's just, I don't know if I could use it for the rest of my life, for example. I will miss things eventually. So I'm probably going to be using the iPhone up until I get my next Android phone, actually, simply because my current Android phone's quite old, it's running Android 6, so the iPhone's definitely better in that regard, so I'm going to keep using it. And I definitely prefer the Apple Watch to my LG G Watch, and that's simply because the G Watch is quite old at this point. And as much as I love the G Watch, the Apple Watch is a bit nicer. And it's a shame that you can't get the Apple Watch to work on an Android device natively, because it's so nice. I love the Apple Watch. So let's get to a conclusion here then. Apple have created a decent phone. I'm not going to dispute that. The iPhone is definitely a good phone. But I think that because they have penny skimped on the battery or something, I don't know what they've done. Either it's bad software or it's just really bad quality batteries inside the iPhone. But I've never spoken to anyone who says the iPhone has perfect battery life. Everyone I've spoken to says it's garbage, even on brand new iPhones. It's just not, it's weird. But if you ignore the battery issues, the iPhone's not too bad. I really liked a lot of the things on it. Apple Pay worked really well, although it worked about the same as Google Pay. Although I did have an issue with Apple Pay, actually. I tried to use it once and it declined the payment. The payment was declined on the machine in the shop, and then it had taken the money from my account, but the machine in the shop said no. And I then had not enough money in my account to do it a second time, so it declined because I had insufficient funds. So after all of that faffing, I ended up having to get someone else to pay for me, and I had to send them the money. I did get a refund automatically after about 8 days, but still, that's not a very smooth experience. I don't know if that's an Apple Pay issue, if it was an issue with MasterCard, if it was an issue with my bank, or an issue with the shop, or an issue with the sun and the moon not lining up on Friday the 13th or whatever, some garbage. But it declined, and it was very, very, very embarrassing, and it's kind of made me a bit wary of using it now. So that's it for this video. Don't forget to leave a comment down below if you liked it. A thumbs up, a thumbs down, they're both sort of the same. And don't forget to subscribe for your dose of tech.
Later, buddy. That's a good one.